Welcome to the course on Land Administration. My name is Peter van Oostrom and I prepared this course together with my colleague Marion de Vries, and we used slides from Christian Lemme and Rowan Bennett. This is an introduction to the topic of land administration. We'll cover four main issues. What is land administration? The importance of standardization in land administration, the use of information modeling by UML class diagrams, and we'll have a look at 3D cluster as a future development. What are the main drivers for land administration? Fiscal, to support taxation. Juridical, to protect the legal status of ownership. And also multipurpose, the above motivations, but also land use planning. In many countries, land administration is seen as a condition for sustainable development, therefore very important. United Nations defines land administration as the process of recording and disseminating information about ownership, value, and the use of land and the associated resources. Think of buildings and trees and other topics. Here in this diagram of McLaughlin and Dale, we see the three aspects: the land value, the land use, and land ownership. We also see that different parts of government are involved. Ministry of Justice, Finance, Ministry of Planning and Environment, Agriculture. So this makes it a complex setting. Here we see in a nutshell the cadastral concepts. On one side the spatial information, parcels on a map, and on the other side ownership information, legal information linked to the parcels via the parcel identifier. The parcel boundaries are basically two types. There are countries that use general boundaries referring to physical features, real world objects, rivers, roads. The other type is called fixed boundaries. These are not directly related to real world features but to precisely surveyed boundaries where buyer and seller agree on the location of the boundaries. So also called coordinate cluster. So cluster consists of two types of information: the spatial information, the maps, the boundaries, parcel identifiers, the administrative information, legal information, what rights or restrictions apply to the parcels, which persons are involved, and of course these two should be linked. The tricky part is, as we saw before, that multiple organizations are often involved. In many countries there is not an operational cadaster or land registry, and it's estimated that only, say, a quarter of the parcels in the world are formally registered. So that leaves a big gap of non-registered parcels. So therefore, we should try to improve the situation, and one attempt is via a standardized approach. The benefits of standards are they support meaningful exchange of data. Remember, in land administration, multiple organizations can be involved. When they exchange data, we have to have good definitions. And this enables interoperability between the systems involved, but also the organizations. We could also say they help building the spatial data infrastructure. Standardization itself is enhancing the quality because the standards are based on knowledge, experience from a global community, and it is also cost effective because we have better fitting components. Industry can develop, say, solutions that are reused, same for open source communities. So therefore, within ISO TC211, the geographic information community, an activity was started to standardize land administration. But you could ask, is this possible? Because there are huge differences, or supposed to be huge differences, between all these cadastral and land registry systems in the world. Every country has own legislation, own software implementation, own set of tools. Okay, despite this question mark, FIG decided in 2002, okay, let's work on standardization. And the FIG is the International Federation of Surveyors. Because basically the information is also much the same. We have land covered by parcels, we have persons using the land, having ownership rights or other rights, and these rights are recorded. in this land administration process. So the result was indeed an official ISO standard with the name ISO 1A105 Land Administration Domain Model, and it covers both the spatial and the legal part. It's a conceptual model, meaning it defines the key concepts, but it's not direct an implementation. The scope of LRDM is a reference model. Okay, it's called land administration, but it's also valid for water spaces, areas above and below the surface. The three packages are the party packages with persons, the legal packages with the rights, restrictions, responsibilities, and the spatial package where also spatial sources, say the surveys, are included, and also representations such as the cadastral maps. It defines a terminology which allows communication between involved organizations and systems, and it is helping countries to start, and on top of this start they can build their national or regional profile application schema. The process is rather lengthy. First, within FIG it took 4 years to develop the first model, the domain model. Then there were a number of preliminary talks within ISO among the players, FIG, ISO, European Normalization Institute, and the actual standardization started in 2008. After a number of phases, in 2012 it became an official standard. Here we see the LRDM project team of ISO TC211 at work in one of the meetings, and here is the result. You can go to the ISO website and download after buying this standard. Okay, here we see a number of examples why standardization was supposed to be very difficult. This is from 5 countries, a list of rights and restrictions with their terms attached. So you see the complexity. The reason, again, the different legal systems. Here is an overview of the main categories of legal systems in Europe. LRDM looks at it from a rather broad perspective. It defines the three legal concepts, right, restriction, and responsibility, in a high-level way. So a right is an action or an activity or a set of actions that a system participant may perform on or using an associated resource. A restriction is something that you are not allowed to do, and a responsibility is the obligation to do something. So these are the three concepts, so rather abstract defined but standardized.